Hey, this is Jonas from Fixation. We're a Norwegian metalcore band, and on Friday we are releasing our new mini album, Speak in Tongues.
Beautiful, Jonas. Thanks for joining us today.
Thank you so much.
Pleasure. So, as you say, Fixation released the mini album Speak in Tongues on October the 11th. So, how are you feeling about it?
Very good. I'm really excited for people to hear it. It's, you know, as any band says, it's our best work yet. It's literally, it's been the most fun, you know, writing and recording process we've had so far. And it feels really, really like a step in the right direction for us. So really excited for people to experience it.
And can you tell us a bit more about it from a musical point of view and what you were going for with it?
So for this record, we wanted to go in a more heavy direction. It's we tried out a bit of stuff that we hadn't done before. You know, last year we were on a bunch of tours and played all over Europe, and we saw so many great heavy bands live. And the energy that they produce live and the energy that the audience gives back really inspired, I think, the sonical part of this record. And we wanted to make something that really hits you in the face in the live part of it. And that's what we did. Throughout the process of this record, we also, but we were certain we wanted to have more screaming than we've done before. And I didn't really know how to do it properly in the beginning of the recording process of this EP or this record. And at the end, or throughout the process, I figured out how to do it, you know, without hurting my voice or without it sounding weird or weak. So a lot of the screaming vocals were actually re-recorded at the end process of the recording.
Imagine those screaming vocals. Like, what? Why did you decide that now was the right time for that to be introduced into Fixation's music?
I think it's always been something that we wanted to do. I've tried learning it for a couple of years, but I didn't really figure it out. And I think for this recording, it had to happen. So I really had to put the gears in and just, you know, figure it out in some way, because we wrote parts that had to have this energy and this raw feeling, this frustration. So I think we didn't really have a plan B for it. We knew that it had to sound like that. So total process for me, because we're adapting for a live for the live shows, and it works, but it's, you know, it's still something you have to figure out along the way. How much can you do it at a time, and where does it fit? And, you know, but we've always listened to heavier music than what we've made. And I think the debut album we wrote, we thought it was heavier because we had some demos that were heavier, but they didn't really make the cut. So it felt like the right time to do it.
And it's also a conceptual collection of music, mate. So what's the premise behind it?
So I've always been fascinated by cults, and that's sort of the general concept of the record. And I also did a bachelor's, and I wrote my final assignment about concept albums. So I knew I wanted to do something more conceptual, because it's always been a part of the music that I love. My favorite albums have always been concept albums, where there's a plot, a storyline, characters, everything. And it really ties into, you know, the whole visual part of a band as well, which I've always found really interesting. So this felt like the right time to write about this, because it's been in our minds for such a long time. And what really fascinates me about cults is the psychological aspect of it. You know, how one person can believe, you know, a false prophet blindly and do everything that they say. And then also how a false prophet can claim that they know better, or that they've been sent by someone to be this messiah that they have to follow. And usually it's for, you know, personal gain. And then whilst writing, I sort of drew connections to other aspects of the society that we live in today. And that's sort of where the concept grew. It's not just in cults, you know, this happens. And that's sort of the main idea that I've taken from the record.
So, what was easy to write, the assignment on conceptual albums or the conceptual album?
Oh, that's a good question. Probably the album, because, you know, there's more passion there than doing a school assignment. But sorry, what'd you say?
Hope so.
Yeah, you know, the school assignment, you have to do all these source writing and stuff like that, and here you have the freedom to do whatever you want because it's our music, so it was easier.
And I noticed there's no song on the mini album called Speak in Tongues, so the title must have a bit of extra significance.
Yeah, it was actually we had a demo from the last album that was called Speak in Tongues, and I thought it was so cool. You know, it sounded great. I think the act of speaking in tongues really weirds me out, and it kind of tickles my curiosity in a good way. So we felt like it sounds like a much cooler album title than just the song. And you know, if you listen to the record, you can hear it in there. It's being said in the lyrics, but we didn't really want it to be that obvious. You know, there's a lot of Easter eggs hidden around the whole record, and a lot of whispers and stuff, and samples and small things that you might have to listen a couple of times before you hear it all. But that's one of the more obvious ones, I guess.
And this comes a year after the release of your debut album, Subtle Then Death. So it's a pretty quick turnaround, mate.
Yeah, we got, you know, we spoke with the record label, and they thought it would be a good time to release a new EP. And you know, being us, we didn't really want to do a four song easy EP. We had to have a bit more than that, and that's where these four interludes came in. So it's, you know, it's eight tracks, but it's four songs, so it's sort of a mini album rather than a full length one. And I think the small interludes in between there really make up this conceptual part of it. It makes it more of a cohesive storyline and sort of a movie soundtrack in some ways. Yeah, I think learning from writing the debut album, we learned a lot about what not to do, how not to spend too much time writing, and also a lot about what our weaknesses and our strengths are within the band, and play specifically on that. So it came, we thought we were able to, you know, we got it out now rather than later.
So Fixation appeared just 4 short years ago in 2020, mate. So what was your early vision for the band and how has it changed since?
So the thing is, we actually started the band when we were like 15, back in high school, and we back then we I think we started out doing some covers of like Radiohead and Muse and Coldplay and stuff like that, and the sound of the songs we made ourselves were a lot more pop rock or alternative rock sort of style, which you probably can hear a bit on the debut album, but it was a lot softer than that again. And we spent like 9 years doing a lot of local stuff from the town we come from, and a bit in Oslo as well, but it didn't really progress further than that. And in 2020, we decided to, sort of reinvent what Fixation was, and start fresh. That's when we made the first EP, Global Suicide. That's also when we signed with Indie Recordings, our label. And since then, things have sort of evolved a lot more and a lot quicker.
So how would you say that, like, we touched on this a little bit before, but how would you say the band's sound has changed from the debut EP Global Suicide through to Speak in Tongues?
I think we're a lot more mature. Back then, we didn't really have a vision for what we wanted to make. I think we sort of made music that we thought sounded cool. It's always been this wanting to have this conceptual thing, but I think the sound is much more refined now. We've learned what we do that sounds good, and what doesn't work, and it's also, never trying to repeat yourself, trying to stray a bit away from what you made in the past in the right direction, and take it to a new level, sort of. And with this release, I think we're going in the right direction for what we want the band to sound like. And I think it's just gonna keep building on that. We're never gonna try to fall back on what we've done before. I don't think any band, should. That's what's great about music is the music that you made in the first years of your career. There's it's still there, but it's cool to see how you progress and how you change and how you evolved as a musician.
So Speak in Tongues is out this Friday, mate, but what's next for Fixation after that? You got any plans?
Not any specific live plans as of yet, but we've started writing new music, and the plan is to be in the studio throughout the year and see what comes of it. Hopefully something pops up next year on the live front, but right now it's nice to just hibernate a bit in the studio and create some new music that hopefully takes us in a new direction again,
All right, Jonas. Well, thanks very much for your time, bro. Speak in Tongues is out this Friday, October the 11th. So, best of luck with it, mate, and we'll talk to you soon.
Spread the word around, so let's start causing random acts of violence. This thing may consider damnable, as you may be in mind. We've got to spread the word around, so let's start causing random acts of violence. Just as you're finally safe, such a congregation, trouble. random acts of violence. This being made considerable as we made it ignite. We've got spreads all around, so let's start causing random acts of violence.